someone here today that can help you speak English, translate for you? Just you? We'll see how it goes. You've been issued a citation for driving without a driver's license. Did you receive that ticket? What do you want to do with it today? Plead guilty, no contest, or not guilty? Understand those choices? What do you want to do with your ticket?
Just for home, for home.
You just want to pay it? Just want some time to pay it?
Yeah.
So you're pleading guilty to the ticket? Okay. Is 60 days enough time for you to pay it? 60 days?
No.
You want to just pay it today?
Yeah, please.
He doesn't have a driver's license.
No, he does not.
Are you an American citizen? Are you a citizen? Are you an American citizen? No? Okay, you can't get a license then, that's just the way the law is. Just not trying to pry, but if you could get a license, we'd have you come back, but you're not going to be eligible, unfortunately, so. We'll give you 60 days to pay it, we'll give you the address for you to mail the payment, okay?
Yeah.
Come on up. Helki is next.
She had these death notes. She had death notes. What do you have?
He's got that.
You have 114?
I have 114 notes.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Mr. Helki, you've issued a citation alleging speeding 79 in 65 by 45, that way there. What's your opinion?
No contest.
Laser Highway 45, first turnaround north of Highway 60, observed vehicle heading northbound Highway 45, high rate of speed, defendant was clocked and locked in at 79 miles per hour in a 65 zone. Laser was checked at noon, defendant sole occupant, he was ID'd by Wisconsin DL. He didn't know he was going that fast. He's got three priors, 109, 07, and 06, all speeding in the media. You drive a lot.
I do.
Anything you want to tell me about?
I was just trying to go to flow traffic. I definitely was, you know, going above the speed, but I didn't realize I was going that fast. So I was just going to see if there's any way, you know, I could get the points reduced and pay the fine.
I don't have to condone people speeding, but I think there's a comment that thought that 72 is about the same, so.
Yeah. I know what you mean.
If you consider that, I don't know.
Yes, exactly.
3 points, 9 over the limit is the standard amendment that the village makes in this case. So it saves you a $9,000 category.
Okay.
$114, can you pay that in 60 days?
Sure. Yeah, not a problem. Come on up. Thanks.
Anyone else? That's awesome. Thank you. This is Mr.
Garnell? Yes.
Sir, you readjourned your case from last month, I believe. I don't know. I don't recall if you entered a plea last month, but if you didn't, what are your pleas to the charges of operating after revocation and operating on suspended registration?
No contest.
Officer observed the defendant's vehicle on 45 at Highway 60. Officer checked the defendant's vehicle's plate on spot computer. The registration was shown as being suspended and registered owner defendant was revoked. Officer initiated traffic stop and ID defendant by Wisconsin Polo DL. Defendant issued and explained site.
Valid now, Mr. Daniel?
Yes, my license, I do have a current driver's license.
What about the vehicle?
My vehicle, 10 more days because I just paid it. I had a lot of parking tickets.
You had a lot of stuff to clean up.
Yeah, a lot of stuff to clean up. So I cleaned it up. I have my my driver's license, and then probably like another 10 days or whatever else, but that's good.
Do you have your criminal license?
Yeah, but I had to wait to go to court in another village.
I remember that. You reopened something?
Yeah, that was the holdup. I just had to wait, because they have once.
That's why we gave you 30 days to clean things up around that, right?
Right. I don't know about the registration.
Right, and brought some next night.
It'd probably be like 10 more days.
Well, that's not really a major problem, because that doesn't have any effect on your licenses. So as to the operating after revocation, you've gotten things cleaned up for now with valid drivers. So the village standard amendment in that scenario is to make that a $0 total license by a person. You didn't have your ID card, you paid the owner, you set the sign up. You're also going to have to pay the suspended registration to the police department. What about paying those two folks for so much time? I know you spent a ton of money to clean things up. It's kind of a strange situation.
Yeah, I would need.
90 days?
I'm still, I'm still going to court or something, but I could pay something today.
So 90 days is fine, okay?
Okay.
Hold up, we'll give you some printouts for that. EK pallets? So, your name?
Dan.
And you're here on behalf of EK pallets?
Yes.
So your company was issued a citation for traveling with an unsecured load on a vehicle on January 21st.
Defendant stopped an unsecured load pallets were stacked on trail in a manner of narrow pallet on bottom of flooded pallets towards pump. Housing stack of pallets to be allowed to site issue and had the defendant restack pallets, wide one on bottom, narrow on top.
Were you the one that had to restack them or something?
No, I wasn't. It was also issued four repair citations, fix the tickets. Fire extinguisher missing, warning devices missing, USDOT number required is not on, and registration found was not up to date.
And that's, I suggest, the
Yeah, but when I went to get them signed off, because I'm from a town hall, they were dumbfounded anyway, because you.
What did you get it to? Where'd you take it?
To the Commonwealth Police Department.
That they were tolerant for labor,
particular
violations?
Well, no, the USDOT number, you need at 10,001 pounds. And I wasn't at 10,001 pounds, or I would have been in violation of being way overweight, because the trailer don't hold that much. So you don't need a USDOT number, and when you have a USDOT number, you need the warning devices and fire extinguisher. And when they called, the Commonwealth called the police department here to confirm, and they said, yeah, that's the way. And then they said, this officer is the one that did it, but you do need to be at 10,001 pound to have it. But I didn't have time to sit there and try to fight it. But as far as the unsecured load, there was a smaller pallet, because there were two stacks, there was a smaller pallet at the bottom that they were 36 wide and the other one was 40, but that's because part was under a four-wheel wheel well. So it's not saying that a load wasn't secured, because they pulled into the gas station, and because I always have my employees check their load, the scraps and loose and all that, whatever, and they tightened it down, and when they left, across the street, the officer was sitting and stopped them, and he even showed the officer, the thing was
hold on the strap.
And he says, he told me, he says, well,